our research is based on a ubiquitous biosensing platform, and this platform will be able to sense a large variety of biomolecules. It will have high sensitivity, high specificity, and multiplexity. In addition, the data quality will be very high, and that will give you reliable data for biosensing. And this is especially important for medical diagnosis because reliability is a key for medical diagnosis. We are currently developing this ubiquitous biosensing platform based on a very new mechanism. And this mechanism, we call it Raman enhancement through 2D materials, or RE2D for short. So Raman signal is a fingerprint for biomolecules. Whenever you see a Raman signal, you will know what type of molecule it is. When you put biomolecules in adjacent to a type of 2D material, which is a specialized type of nanomaterial, you will see a strong enhancement of the Raman signals of the biomolecules. Our group is the forerunner of this RE2D field. We actually developed the first biosensing platform based on RE2D for a series of biomolecules, including blood proteins, neurotransmitters, and cancer cells. It will benefit a number of medical areas, including the point of care medicine and cancer research, as well as Alzheimer's disease and even infectious diseases. In addition, we will integrate it onto a chip so you can attach it onto your body and can do continuous health monitoring for yourself. My PhD advisor was Professor Millie Dresselhaus. She is really a forerunner and a leader in promoting women in science. So I was deeply inspired by her effort and her life devotion to women in science. I decided to carry on her wisdom and her spirit in promoting women in science. I initiated a graduate women mentoring group at Penn State. So for the initial phase, we started the mentoring group in my department. Graduate women can ask a number of questions to their mentors in terms of a broad range of topics, including work-life balance, how to navigate grad school, and their future career choices. The graduate women will feel more comfortable navigating the graduate school if they have a female mentor who had the same experience before. We plan to expand the program to other departments in the future, as well as to other campuses at Penn State. I believe that as female scientists and female engineers, we need to be confident in ourselves that we can do equally well. We can also have the same ambition for our future career choices.